Definitely, I was brought up to believe, you know, Africa is the motherland.
When I think of Africa, I think of the motherland. And honestly, like, I think of my ancestors and the jungle.
When I think about Africa, I think hope.
A misconception about Africa. A lot of people, when they think of Africa, they think of, you know, jungles, you know, uncivilized people, but they don't realize that Africa is keeping up, like, with the world right now, like, the technology, everything, like, just buildings, everything, like, it's a modern environment, modern, like, civilization right now, like, just like America, Africa, we have cell phones, houses, cars, all that type of stuff. People don't see that, so, yeah, Africa, you know, I think people just need to get this misconception out of their head, keep moving forward.
Some bad things about it, it's a divided country, it's a divided continent, not country, but all the countries, if they were united, it would be a pretty strong country. They'll be able to survive by themselves without outside help, but right now, they need help from other countries because they're so divided, and that brings a lot of chaos and things like that. But for the most part, there's places where it's pretty nice and people are really getting along well and it's prospering, but what you see on TV is not, it's not always what defines Africa, so don't believe it.
Definitely, I was brought up to believe, you know, Africa is the motherland, first and foremost. And you think of, like, the creation of life. All life on this planet started out in Africa and then diverged. Unfortunately, I guess with, like, all the images that we see and what we've been taught, especially in this country, people of African descent, is a lot of savagery. And it makes sense about all the ignorance that pretty much surrounds Africa. And the first problem is that we think of Africa as, like, one country and a group of one people instead of Africa actually being a continent made up of 52 countries and diverse people. And I think with the ignorance, all that comes along, you know, like, periods of colonization and definitely slavery and how they affect people. And as, like, an African-American, we automatically think about the history of Africa and where it is now. And black people as a whole trying to improve themselves from where they've been. But definitely beauty and struggle when I think about Africa.
When I think of Africa, I think of the motherland, and honestly, like, I think of my ancestors and the jungle. That's it. I know that sounds dumb. I do think of all the, you know.
Yeah, I think of tribal stuff, too. Like, to me, I feel like I'm not really connected to it because I'm like, I don't know.
But we're all connected to it,
though. I know, but it's like, I feel like not directly because, you know, because I'm two things. So it's like, you know, the Puerto Rican and the Guyanese, I'm not like directly. I mean, I know we are.
We're all from the motherland.
I know we are, but to me, I feel like it's more of a struggle for me, because, you know,
we're going to have to fix that, because we're all family in this world, honestly.
Can we cut?
When I hear the word Africa, the first thing I think of is the motherland, the place where life started for all human beings. And when I think of it today, it actually saddens me to see how far it's come from being kings and queens to the level of poverty today, AIDS running rampant throughout the country, and the social economic standing of Africans and African Americans in America today. It truly makes me sad. Like, I mean, we're here in college, and I mean, that's the best we could do is to uplift our people, is to get an education. Is that good?
Mm-hmm. I want to go there one day.
That's what you think about Africa?
No, I think Africa will be, like, the ultimate, like, place to go just to see, like, where my ancestors came from. I want you to take me to Ghana, son. For real. Just take me to Ghana and we'll have fun.
I was born and raised in Ghana. I lived there for 12 years of my life. I love that country a lot. And when I think about Africa, I think about potential. I see a lot of potential in African itself. I see a lot of potential in African countries. I see a lot of positiveness just coming out of that country itself. I feel like it's very inspiring. Africa is starting from the beginnings of, you know, where they got, how long they've had their independence compared to other nations, is definitely advancing at a faster rate than they did 50 to 60 years from now. Africa and the nations itself are going to be somewhere very recognizable. Like I said, there's potential. I definitely see a lot of new things. I see a lot of new African countries that are thinking very different, or again, now in the economic mainstream, they're making a lot of major moves. The ugly part of it is we're still not united. You know, the government itself is still not helping the people as a whole, and there's still a lot of corruption in Africa itself. Certain oil-producing countries in Africa are not, the money is not being circulated. The money is being stagnant. It's stuck at one place. So the ugly is we're not there yet. We want to be there, but we're not there yet. We're not making the moves to be united in general. Think about Africa, I think hope.
Hey, I say, Africa must wake up, the sleeping sons of Jacob, for what tomorrow may bring, may a better day come. Yesterday we were kings, can you tell me, young ones, who are we today? Yeah, now. Well, Africa must wake up, the sleeping sons of Jacob, for what tomorrow may bring, may a better day come. Yesterday we were kings, can you tell me, young ones, who are we today?
The black oasis, ancient Africa, the sacred awaken, the sleeping giant, science, art is your creation. I dreamt that we could visit old Kemet. Your history is too complex and rigid for some Western critics. They want the whole subject diminished, but Africa's the origin.